New update is here. Insanely detailed geometry, multi-view support, more accurate 4K textures, and portrait mode. All of this in Hitem3D 1.5, and we're gonna review it right now. Hi guys, this is Stef, and I got early access to Hitem3D 1.5 update, and it's absolutely crazy. This is not sponsored video at all, and we're gonna judge it honestly and compare it with top-notch models such as Tripo V3 and Hunyuan 2.5. Okay, so the update basically looks like that. There is a version 1.5. They added different resolutions. So before it was 1K and 1.5. Now they added 512, which they call cost efficient, and 1536 Pro, which is very interesting. And they improved head mode. Texture do exist for a while right now, but it also got updated and became better. And multi-view support, which we also gonna test. Right, so as a reminder, Hitem3D started as Spark3D and actually made some noise because of crazy detailization. At some point, it was definitely most detailed model, and we'll see if they're keeping pace. As you might learn from my previous video, Tripo also released a huge update, which we will be comparing today. As a benchmark, as usual, let's use a simple yet detailed Android female bust with plenty of details on arms, neck, and hair, and crazy detailed steampunk clock with a clockwork. And for multi-view, let's use my old Polaroid reference of real-world product. Guys, while this video is not sponsored, I still managed to get 3 Pro subscription on new version, and I will give away it for you in 3 days for those who leave the best comment under this video. And don't forget about Discord, there will be more giveaways, promo code sharings, and insights. Okay, so first let's start with basic high quality, and let's do first test without texture and then generate texture on top. So one thing I need to highlight is that generation here takes more than average compared to another AI tools, but in exchange of insanely detailed level. So let's see if it's worth it.
A few moments later.
So after a few minutes, we do have the model here. All right. Right away, I can tell I am impressed how accurate details are. They are logical. Well, I mean, if we compare to the original one, I would say it's nearly perfect for this face. It is still quite simple reference, but I mean, this is amazing. Just look at this. And even these things, like, I mean, everything is shaped perfectly, and like the pattern here, the dragon here. I mean, I really like the result. This item is probably my favorite so far. The cool thing they added actually is that you can free retry within a run, which is amazing. I believe each tool that has expensive generations like Rodin and Tripo must have free retry, because this is important. Rodin do have that. Hitem do have this right now. And I believe Tripo will do this as well. And right from here, we can actually generate a texture. Let's give it some time.
5 minutes later.
And after some time, we have this result. And to be honest, a little bit of spoilers, this is probably most amazing results for today's video. I was really surprised that all the details and the colors are almost exactly the same as on image. The downside is that it actually baked the reflection here, right? But to be honest, it looks good, and the material properties also make some sense, right? I'm not sure if this is a complete PBR, but it looks dope. Let's compare the same thing in Tripo. Okay, here we are in Tripo, and here is my results. And you can tell the difference right away. Although geometry is actually following, there are details, but like, let's say in this part it is simplified. Unfortunately, I do not have access to Ultra right now. Maybe it will be better, but I'm testing with Vichy that I have access right now. Also, if we go to solid mode, we can see the details are definitely on another level. And I also did the same within Hunyuan 2.5, which actually also very interesting. I would say I like it more than Tripo, maybe because it's glossy, but frankly speaking, Hunyuan usually do everything too glossy. But in terms of details, well, there are definitely way less details on geometry, but they look accurate, which I like. And I really don't understand why geometry also has this sort of flat edges that are smoothened on top, which looks very weird. And this like always happened like with Hunyuan 2.5. For me, objectively speaking, this one is a no-brainer winner. This is really good. I mean, it is actually possible to just take this asset, drop into the game, and it will melt with the environment. It will look realistic as it can be. The only downside is probably this baked reflection. All right, let's move on to a next one. We're gonna test our Android's female busts, and we'll use 1536 Pro, and we'll do texture right away.
11 minutes later.
Okay, this one took fairly longer, around 10 minutes. But here we are. And well, this is amazing. This is really amazing. I'm a little bit speechless because it's not only adding details, right? It's not just adding like geometry. They are logical. Look. These cables, they are like from end to bottom, and all these connections and gears. I mean, this is amazing. Wow. I really like it. One thing I don't understand is why there are two ponytails. And I was like trying to figure out. But the thing is, if you look at from here, it looks exactly as reference. Like, and I like it a lot. What is this on the small artifact here in texture? It's something with the eyes. Yeah, I guess like because on the reference, they are also like covered by reflection. But if we not look in the eyes, everything else is nearly perfect. But there is always a but. And it's about the polygons. Yes, this details level achieved by plenty of polygons. And why I'm saying plenty is like 1 million at least. And I saw it can go higher. And we also have three retries here. Let's see how far we can go on Tripo with the same reference. All right, so here we go. Again, I don't have access to Ultra yet. So it's created in V3 with HD textures. Well, basically the max I can get from it. And here is the result. Well, which is interesting, there is one ponytail. But it's not that detailed. I guess it's like sort of simplified. Yeah, you can see there's like a lot of like small strands within the ponytail. But in this case, it's like generalized, like simplified. For the face, I would say it's actually not bad. Just get me right. Like compared to what it was before on Triple, this one is good. It's like painted on top of inaccurate geometry, right? So geometry is like this, and that's why that's not really it, right? So again, it's not a bad result. I really like how where things goes, but compared to what I see here, well, this is like, well, you see it yourself, and details like look how accurate, how sharp they are. Let's take a look on Hunyuan. All right, so something really wrong with eyes. Lashes in the middle of the eye. I guess, yeah, it's not really working with faces. Yeah, and everything is, yeah, as you can see, like this like sort of cap for details, how much details you can take care of. And yeah, you see like this flattened, and in this case, well, Tripo V3 and Hitem 100% better than Hunyuan in the current condition. I guess Hunyuan V3 will do better. For now, it's not close. All right, and let's do one more test with our ultra detailed Steampunk clock with a clockwork.
A few moments later.
And here we go. It also took around 7 to 8 minutes. First of all, details in terms of geometry are insane. Well, just look at this. Just look at this. I mean, well, do I need to comment this, right? It's like, it's really cool. It's not melting anything. Like, geometry is insanely accurate, but texture losing it, right? So maybe because this so much detail in the 4K texture is not enough, which I would say like if I was the artist creating this, well, definitely one 4K texture is not enough for such amount of details. So we can see it actually loses on the edges, and it actually brings some chaos, but even though it looks amazing, let's see how Tripo can do that. All right, here we go. So I guess, yes, for this task, we'll definitely need to wait Ultra. I don't know when it's coming, but I guess soon, because this one is a mess, right? So you can see how drastically different it is, right? Look at this sharp, accurate, precise details. Like, it's almost perfect round shapes. I mean, this is insane. So it's actually trying, and I like how it's cheating. Has basically created like a solid back. And yeah, the same problem with texture, but I mean, the material here is definitely more shinier. I guess this one is still not a real material, right? And another guest of honor is Hunyuan. Well, This one is also kept from backside, but it looks better than Tripo, to be honest, right? I guess it's just a solid, right? No artifacts. Well, it's actually good. Like from this side, the texture is good, but because it simplifies things, right? Actually not bad. I would say like this one is better than Tripo. Yeah, well, you can see the geometry, right? I would admit that Hitem is not that good at texturing yet. Maybe because they need to consider like using few textures and stuff. I believe that's a very complicated task. But again, like if we turn off texture and let's say I will continue working on this geometry. I mean, this is insane. Like just look at this. I mean, we were impressed with Spark 3D, right? When it was V1, but this one is really impressive. So here it is. Let's give it also a try for multi-view. All right, here we go, and let's click generate.
5 minutes later.
Well, I can say that from previous tries, the shape is way more logical, but texturing is not an accurate, unfortunately. Well, we do not expect any text to be accurate. So here, everything is messed up. But if we do ignore text, I think it's not that bad, but these controls, they are completely messed up. Well, not bad, but not really impressive. But from my testing, like multi-view is not really there anywhere. So yeah, keep going, guys. And the last thing I want to test is so-called head mode. All right, so I will use basically the same one. I'm not sure it's supposed to be bust or head only, but let's give it a try.
5 minutes later.
And here is the result. You can see like head 3. And frankly speaking, I like my generation in pro mode more than this. It actually ruined eye rendering, like lashes on top of the eye. The face itself I like less, the details are less, and so on. I really like it more here, right? I can just paint on top eyes and it's, well, this is perfect. I really like it. But I saw examples from developers. So here it is. Here is an example from developers where eyes are rendered better. Yeah, as you can see, lashes are rendered as a geometry, and well, this actually brings some level of problems, I guess. This is something you really don't want to use, and even though like the original image is like this, I think this is like work in progress, and personally I don't see use of this tool a lot, but maybe as a basis if you do portraits, busts and stuff. Well, but it's definitely more accurate than another tools in industry. That one I can assure you. Also, I want to show one cool example I found from developers. This one is absolutely insane. Here is the reference they use, right? I don't really have such detailed reference. I guess like this is like you need to ask ChatGPT, like create me like 100 details per square meter, a million details per square meter, like, and we go get this image, and guess what, it actually do all the details. Just look here. I mean, that's probably too much, but the thing is, like, I was just thinking, right, you're developing some game on Unreal Engine, you just drop an image here, get the asset, boom, you just drop it in the game, and Unreal Engine Nanit system will just render that as is, like, and wow, this is so cool. And guys, don't forget to bookmark my tier list. I'm keeping it updated, and as you can see, there are changes. The link is in the Discord and it's absolutely free. And one thing to mention is you can actually export in 4 most popular formats, which is more than enough, at least for me. And here is how it looks in Blender, for example. It exported with texture, looks amazing. But for mesh, yeah, it's just a very dense mesh. Let's remove this. Yeah, you can see, well here it is, just very high poly dense mesh. Even though it like doesn't look like crazy, depending on the purpose, you can easily like decimate it in Blender or any other software. Like, so here, for example, I just cut almost 90% of volume and it still looked decent. Well, depends on the use case. That's it for today, guys. Don't forget about giveaway. Please like and subscribe. I really appreciate your support. See you next video.